Mr. Stan Shih, thank you for this interview.
Yes.
In 2004, you retired at the age of 60. Back then, you said the Chinese tend to work until they can't work anymore, and that's just wrong. But 9 years later, you were pulled back into Acer at around the time when the company you built was dealing with losses. It's been 4 years since. Has Acer turned a corner? Is Acer doing better now?
I think so. I think after I back to Acer, immediately we take many action. They cut the cost, lay out the vision and the future direction. And it seems that every quarter is more than break even. It's very just a little bit profit only. Mm-hmm. But that's the foundation for the transformation, because we have to leverage the current PC business and also technology, transform to a new direction. In year 2000, I do a major transformation called the New Acer. And this time, I call this transformation is New Acer. Transform from a hardware company to become a hardware plus software plus service, especially to welcome the cloud era.
So what is your outlook for the next perhaps 3 to 5 years? Because market share of Acer continues to fall a little bit, stock price, which is the measure of investor confidence, continues to decline as well. So what is the outlook?
I think the PC total available market is decline every year. And although our marketing share is dropped, but we start to making profit. That's more important. It's no sense to, in order to keep the marketing share, you lose the money. But the issue is we can leverage this foundation to welcome the new opportunity. So I create a new terminology called bring your own cloud, our approach to welcome the cloud era. And I also, in order to welcome the Internet of Things, I create a name called Internet of Beings, human beings, Internet of Beings. If things without being, there's no value at all. So people talking about Internet of Things, I talking about Internet of Beings. And right now, the company is transformed to a beingware company. Beingware is hardware plus software plus the cloud service. That is the new direction for Acer. It's more software. Original Acer is hardware company, but what I talk every day is about software, about service.
Are you bowing out of the hardware business?
No, we still keep, because I consider the hardware is the carrier to deliver the service. Without hardware, the service cannot fulfill the user need. We have to make sure our customer, we deliver a good service, help them to do business or to enjoy the life.
Right now, with this mix, hardware, software, service, what is the revenue mix? Oh. How much of the business is hardware? How much is software?
Today is almost still, most is hardware. But you will see the new business after 3 years of the development and a lot of effort. And we are in the process for accelerator. You can see a takeoff above the ground. It's just a little bit, but it takes some more years. I think another 2-3 years. And if you like to see the contribution on the new business, compared to all the business, or more than 50%, maybe take 5 to 10 years.
The software business, what are you doing in the software business aside from cloud?
Right now, we are target, for example, for the unified communication, mm-hmm. this new way for switching all the telephone, or not only the voice, also the instant message and the video conference. We are provide that platform for office application. We also participate on a digital signage, but now it's more in smart signage. So you have a content management system in the cloud platform. You can deal with tens of the thousand display centralized in global setup. Mm-hmm. That will be the new way to manage the digital signage. So, and we also have a special tablet for the senior citizen more than 75 years old. We also have a computer dedicated for the bicycle fund. We also have a computer for the pet.
Pet. Like a pet dog?
Yes, the dog, cat.
Okay.
Yeah. Actually, we don't name that is computer. In Acer, in the future, we don't name our product is computer. This computer is disappear, but it's everywhere inside. So, on segmentation.
Mr. Shih, when you think of Acer, we usually think along the lines of utilitarian. It's something we use for work, something we use for the office, unlike the brands of Apple, where it's a lifestyle brand. When do you see Acer becoming more a lifestyle brand, more than just a utilitarian brand?
I think it takes some more time because it's more required on user-centric and customer insight. My foundation in 4 years ago, I have a special organization called Chinese Consumer Center. Try to understand what the insight for the user in the future after they retire or in the, what they like to enjoy. And we like to understand the customer insight, define the trend of the need. Then we provide a right service. We need is B2B2C. Mm-hmm. So we are transformed to hold more a user-centric, mm-hmm. you know, company. It's not easy from Taiwan because Taiwan local market is very, very small. So the company they need a scale. So they always looking into the global market. Taiwan is number one in the silicon technology, in more advanced, and the marketing share is number one in the world. So we have a good base, but our innovation more in the technology centric. But if you're talking about civilization, it's all related to the culture, with the daily life. So that you need a new innovation in more emotional approach. In the past, it's more rational approach. Mm-hmm. So I think Taiwan still need to enhance the emotional innovation capability.
You sound very optimistic, Mr. Shih, but a few years ago, in a separate interview, in a different interview, you did say that you welcome corporate takeovers, a corporate takeover, but it did come with a warning that the potential buyer would likely get an empty shell. I guess what I want to ask is, are you still open to a corporate takeover today after seeing the development or the progress that Acer has made over the past few years? And what did you mean by an empty shell then?
I think I really like to see a sustainability of the Acer. Actually, Acer have a three unit in semiconductor merged by TSMC, a IC design company merged by MediaTek, and the telecommunication company take over by Foxconn. All leading company in Taiwan. I am open on that because I see keep all the stakeholder, the benefit is most important, but sustainability is important. The Acer is quite unique in the Asia. A very big value, brand awareness, global setup, and the service capability is a unique. That reason, if someone only looking into, oh, this is good price, stock price to take over the Acer, without thinking about help the Acer to sustain in the long run, then is not so welcome. And we are not making money, actually is important to sustain, but it's not the main purpose. Main purpose of Acer or all the people is try to contribute to the society. If you don't create value, so keeping create the new value is important. So a mature industry like PC have a limit of value. Mm-hmm. Although it's big scale, the room is smaller. And you have to leverage that, looking for the new opportunity. Even I mentioned about some new approach of the pet computer or bike computer. We all acquire a small company and that help them to run independently using the Acer intangible and the tangible asset or strengths to help them to. So keep the entrepreneurship, but in the same time, bring in the professionals into that. In past 5 years, I keep him promote a Wang Dao philosophy. Wang Dao in Chinese means king's way, leadership way.
Wang Dao.
So I have a three core way principle called create value, balance of interest to all the stakeholder, and then sustainable development. So we have to make sure when you're talking about value, you reflect to six aspects, direct, indirect, tangible, intangible, current, and the future. But unfortunately, the capitalism, democracy system, management system, they are more pay attention on visible value. Current, tangible, direct. But as a leader, you have to pay more attention the balance between visible and the invisible. If you don't invest in invisible way, the create those value, then you cannot sustain. That's the reason after retire, in the first half of our retirement, our group grow from 22 billion to more than 60 billion. But after second half of that, they slow down. Even the Acer itself is, dropped. And the revenue is in the keep lose for 3 years. And that's because they don't invest in the long run. They don't invest to create the invisible value.
How about succession plans? You were once quoted as saying, Acer is solid and stable, but a little bit old-fashioned, which is ironic because you're in the tech industry, but now your son has joined the company. Is he the new blood that you feel will lead the next generation of
my
Acer?
My first major function after back to Acer as a chairmanship, the first is succession plan in all positions. And ask many of the senior executive to retire. And the current, the first time manager, the president we under the CEO, they have many priests, all younger, 40 some years old.
Finally, Mr. Shih, your story, the story of Acer, how you left the company to retire, came back, and now you're running a new Acer. Many people compare it to the story of Steve Jobs of Apple. He set up Mac, left the company. When the company was a bit of in trouble, he came back. He launched iPhone, iPod, the iPad, and the rest, as they say, is history. Apple is not such a big company. Do you think that is your story? Do you think that is the story of Acer, that your return is, in a way, the renaissance, the rebirth of Acer?
Yeah, I think I just try to do my personal social responsibility, PSR. Mm-hmm. It's not CSR. As a person, personal social responsibility. And I hope Acer can become a great company in the world, but not my, you know, effort. Actually, many, many of young generation, they have to put effort on that way. And I believe our challenge from Taiwan relatively small than a company in US or a company in China. It's a small market, and people doubt. And because of people doubt, that is good to me, because me too is not my style. I always like to doing something can be unbelievable. A big challenge. My motto is challenge the difficulty. Break through the bottleneck, create value.
Okay. Thank you very much, Mr. Stan.
Thank you.